How's it going, YouTube? Back with another one. I'm gonna be 100% honest, this is gonna be a little bit of a hodgepodge video. Lack of motivation, kind of blew away Saturday, trying to be productive Sunday, and here's what I got for you so far. We've got the transmission crossmember for the school car out. Those bolts are just loose, but nice and cleaned up. All the hardware here, nice and cleaned up. I got one steering rack bracket here cleaned up. And just for a before and after kind of thing, this is pretty much what all of it looked like. All greasy and grimy and covered in dirt. So I got this one more to clean up. All this stuff's clean and ready to go. And we'll get onto it. All right, so I showed you the before, and that is the after. So that's, like I said, pretty much all of this looked like that. It's all cleaned up. There it is. Sometimes it's the little bit of tinker time that you do and the little tiny things like cleaning up hardware, cleaning up parts, that kind of thing that pays off dividends later. So even when you have a hard time getting motivated and that kind of thing, keep grinding, keep doing you. Also, if you watched the last video that I did on the school car on Thaya, we took the crossmember and everything out. Earlier on in that clip, you watched me jack the car up and put on jack stands on dirt because it doesn't rain in Arizona. And then it rained immediately after I made that video. So, one at a time, I lifted the car up by each side, took jack stand out, packed the dirt back down, and laid this plywood underneath it, and set the car back down on jack stand. Now, technically, this is still pretty sketchy. This is not supposed to be like super long term, but it's a lot safer than what it was. Just didn't want the jack stands were kind of settling awkward, and you know, they do that too much, the car will roll off the jack stands, be on the ground, then I gotta figure out a way to lift the car back up, and it's a pain, it's a mess. Also, since I was going to the hardware store for the wood to put underneath the car, it took a little time. I got some more bricks and topsoil, and I actually got a bell pepper and jalapeno plant for the garden, so figured I'd show you guys that real quick. I know it's not really car related, but this is just what I'm getting done today. So we've had that, rosemary, basil, mint. Got some beans planted there. Those little sprouts will vine up that, hopefully. We've had the tomato plants, and now we've got some jalapeno and bell pepper going there. I don't know if I'm just getting older or more mature or what, but I started gardening like last year and never did it before. Never in a million years, but there's something really relaxing about that. So when I'm having a stressful day, you know, I like to go out there and just pick weeds and that kind of stuff. And you'll be surprised on how much that calms you down and just kind of lifts your spirits. It's good stuff. But let's be real. You come here for car content. So car content you get. Very next thing on the list, which we probably won't get to in this video, are these door hinges need to be adjusted. This one's not so bad, the passenger side is horrible. Also, they've got no door handles inside or out. So I've got the door handles, I've got all the links and everything, I just need to actually put that in. That's going to be coming up next. But for now, I'm actually going to be heading off to my buddy's house. He's got some welders, and we're going to be replacing the downpipe on my car. We're gonna be building a new one because the one that I have right now cracked. It separated from the V-band. Basically, it was running open header, and I need to get the car back to the tuner, and the tuner prefers we have a full exhaust in the car. So for his sake and mine and my neighbors, heading off to my buddy Andrew's house, we're gonna do the downpipe, and we're gonna get that hopefully done today so that maybe if we get it done fast enough, I can go put it on tonight. But at least this week, we'll get it put on the car. And then once that's in, I can start planning and scheduling the next dyno session where I can bring it back to the tuner and we can put the car back on the dyno, get it all sorted and buttoned up for the showdown, which is an event in Tucson that's happening February 13th and 14th. So kind of in a time crunch. I got like 6 weeks to get everything all said and buttoned up so that I can get the car ready to go, so that I can go maybe a week before and hit the same track for some practice laps before the showdown actually happens. So
what are you working on?
Exhaust.
Broken exhaust.
Trying to make not broken anymore. All right, so I was just showing this really cool trick. Andrew, what trick were you just showing us?
So this is a way, so we have a broken piece of David's 8.6 exhaust. What happens is my welding wasn't very good and the car's too low. So it just hit the ground and broke the V-band off. So what we're trying to do is replicate this pipe in a piece of brand new pipe. And this trick is, how do we know exactly where the original pipe was cut? So this was originally a J-bend or a U-bend, and it got cut right at this line where the weld is. So we know that's a predictable line for where the cut is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of make a straight jacket for the pipe. Make this out of just painter's tape, and I'll show you how it works. So this is all the tape layered up, pushed down, and you can see there's only really one way this will kind of, you could just jiggle it around, one way this will fit. You can see all the pieces come back together pretty good. And you couldn't slide this off the pipe. Yeah, there we go. So now it's sitting really flush. You can see those gaps are nice and tight. So the trick is putting the tape on and then how to cut it. Now that we have, you know, once you have the template, do the same big thing. It's gotta be the same radius. You can see we've already marked this, but I drew an inside line and an outside line. So line it up roughly with the inside. Probably should have erased that line first. And as you get this thing back together by working it around, you're doing the same thing as you just did on the other pipe. Get all that lined up, and you can see we cheated already. Already put the line on it. But once you're happy with how tight this is, you pretty much have your cut line because it's transferred directly from your old one.
Yeah. Whatever, just roll.
Welcome back to Andrew's Tuesday Tech Tips, now presented on Sunday evening. So the way we wrap this with tape is we want to get this tape really to follow on the contours. So I'm gonna start on this inside edge and just lay it down. We're gonna work it so the tape flexes. The problem is the tape doesn't want to flex over this compound curve. It's curving both this way and around the pipe. So you just got to kind of work it in there. Make sure you get the tape stuck down real good. Put it down. Just working the tape around. So now what we're doing is we're just pushing the tape down, just smoothing it out, trying to get these wrinkles from fat to real thin like that. It's working our way around. Make sure we get this weld line real nice. And then what we're gonna do is take our Sharpie. We're gonna go chase this weld bead. Later we'll cut this off. Dirty enough fingers, just rub them on this line. also gonna cut this back excess off. Okay, now's the real fun part. Since I have a computer brain, I can just digitally analyze this and figure out how to cut it. So this will take some practice or get a computer brain. So what we want to do is cut a slit in here so we can unwrap the tape, but we want to do it smartly, because if we just have a straight line, it's going to be really hard. We're going to have to bend, open it really up here, and remember, if we have a compound curve, so currently this is only curved in this direction, if we have that curve and kind of this curve as it goes around, it's not going to want to fold there. It's just too much in the way. So we want to kind of relieve some of that burden. If we're on the complete side of the pipe, that's a good start to start. And then come down the spine. Also gonna draw, this will be the outside line. Just gonna draw like something like that. This is like if you've ever done roll cages and you've notched your tubes by hand. Shout out people that have that go through that. Yeah, it's bring a fit. And then we'll cut on this black line. We'll cut up to like here. So leave this uncut. And actually, yeah, it's gonna be sharp no matter what. We'll get our razor blade. We'll start cutting. Just gonna cut this back section off. This is just waste. This mark doesn't mean anything. So we now can take this back stuff off. And if you remember, we layered the tape starting here and just kind of went in one direction. What that does is as we peel this off, as we get down to the bottom layer, the next layer is always on top of the previous layer. So as we peel it up, it'll all come off as one layer until that happens. But we just take this off. Down quite hard. Now I'm rolling the pipe and trying to hold the razor blade straight. Remember, we're gonna leave that section uncut. And that's gonna make this a one piece straight jacket. So anywhere the tape's doubled up, it's gonna give us issues. So don't go crazy ripping this off. Make sure we can really cut through here. Yeah, look at that, it's looking nice. So now, in the same direction that we applied the tape, because remember we rolled the pipe away from us. If you're on a crack, just roll that pipe away. It's no good for you. Now we're getting to our cut. And at any point, you could squish it back down if the layers separate. If you're not as good as this, as I am, see, I'm not even that good. Just kind of push it down. You ever been peeling the vinyl apart and doing the transfer paper at 2 a.m. before a two-day track day just so you can make 20 bucks from your buddy who just finished his car? You could practically do this in your sleep. Oh, I done screwed up. So no problem, just push the tape back down. It's contoured to what we're doing. Just gonna push the tape back down. Probably should have done this from the start. What's the problem here? Let's go to that. Kind of got Is that techno? Peel this bottom part off. Remember, always working towards this, rolling the pipe away. Whack is whack. You know, it's really whack. Government war on drugs. Legalize it. Okay, so now what we're gonna do, this was the line from the weld line. So we're just gonna trim everything off above that. Our map and our globes aren't the same thing. Because a straight line wrapped around a curve ain't gonna be straight no more. Ta-da.
But what we're doing down here, because we don't want this sticky as we put it on the new pipe, it's just not going to help with adjusting and positioning it. This is just some dust. It's Arizona. It's usually really dusty, but it rained. I think the second time this year it rained. So we're just out here putting dust on here. You can see this isn't sticky or anything, and then just kind of wiping off any excess just to make it kind of clean again. But now it's just like construction paper. So now that we're back to our original pipe, we have our template. This line I marked out on, and we know which way this is going to face, we just don't know where exactly. So we're going to start with this outline on the outside radius of the bend, and then just kind of start wrapping our template around. Oh yeah. So there's going to be some gap at the end, it's not a perfect science, but what we can do now. Hold this tight. We're just gonna take a Sharpie. This thing ain't gonna fit. We have stupid big gaps there. So until you kind of get that to its happy place, it's like a round peg in a round hole. It's only gonna wanna sit there in one way. So now we have our cut line. We have our old piece. The problem with this geometry and transferring it over without a method such like this is it's really hard to actually get them aligned because this one's bent. It's got an O2 bung. But, I don't know. Do your best, cameraman.
I'll just leave this in for B-roll, I don't know.
Go on Sideways 86 number 2 channel and see the uncut raw of us talking trash to each other because David's got a broken back and my back hurts because I'm older than him. It's not really trash talking. Yeah, you should totally start another channel that's just uncut.
Alright.
Hello, it's me, I'm back. Down here, like sewer scum, but like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are down there, I guess they.
So here we are back in high society indoors where the heat's warm, not on the ground picking up dust.